The principle of common fate is an important Gestalt principle. It states that objects that are synchronized, or coordinated in movement, are likely to be grouped as one. We witness common fate often in nature: flocks of birds, armies of ants, and schools of fish. Think about the school of fish. It may be over 1,000 individual fish, but because they move synchronously as one, our brains group them together. If you have a phone with multiple home screens, you see common fate at play every day as you navigate through them. When you swipe, the icons move in unison, along with the page indicator at the bottom. Because they move in synchronous, meaning at the same time, same speed, on and off the screen rather than one by one, we mentally think of them as one. Now, common fate is different than other Gestalt principles because of its use of movement and animation, and in a lot of cases can actually supersede other Gestalt principles. Take these six squares, for example. While the principle of similarity would have us perceive them one way, by applying coordinated movement, we override their original groups and now associate these elements that move together as one, regardless of their original perceived groupings. Now, a key element in applying this principle is that the elements that we perceive as one move at the same speed, at the same time, and in the same direction. For example, you can see if we break this uniform motion, the principle is weakened, and it becomes less likely that our brains will group them as one. So let's take a look at specific UX examples. A straightforward application of common fate is a drop-down, expandable menu, or accordion. In each of these, new elements often animate or appear on the screen in unison, allowing the user to focus their attention and quickly comprehend them as a group. Common fate also applies to horizontal or parallax scrolling. Cards, or other interface elements, scroll in a uniform motion and follow a common path, helping the user associate them as one group. Now, what's cool about common fate is that we can also use the disruption of common fate to our advantage, whether it be to draw attention or signal change. This is achieved through unexpected motion that goes against other animation or movement occurring. So as you can see, common fate is a powerful principle to have in our toolbox. By keeping movement synchronous, we can help the user comprehend groups, thus decreasing their cognitive load. Inversely, we can use it to draw the user's attention by disrupting synchronous animation or movement. In fact, now that you're paying attention, you'll see just how often you use common fate to perceive the things around you.